born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. He comes forth like a flower and withers. He flees like a shadow and continues not. Lord, let me know my end and what is the measure of my days. Let me know how fleeting my life is. Behold, thou hast made my days a few hard breaths, and my lifetime is nothing in thy sight. Sure, every man stands at a mere breath. Praise the Lord. Hymn, Amazing Grace. Welcome everyone as we here to celebrate the life of Tariq Sebi. Pray God's comfort on Mom Marcia Smarts and Dad Carl, daughter Naja, and family and friends. Let's bow our hearts in prayer. Father and God, we thank you this afternoon that we could come to look to you as the God of all comfort. We thank you, Lord, for Tariq, dear Lord, for his life, for your favor that you grant him, dear Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you have been with him, and he is with you now. We ask you, Lord, that you will comfort hearts that mourn. You comfort his mom, his dad, his daughter, his siblings, Lord, his family, dear Lord, his friends, dear Father, that you would give peace. You would give hope. You would give rest. You would give, dear Lord, expectations, dear Lord. We pray, Lord, that you will allow your presence to be felt here in this service. We pray, Lord, that you will dry tears and that you will comfort, dear Lord. have your way in this service this afternoon. And I pray, Lord, that you will give us, Lord, the expectation that we can look forward to for hope that is a living hope in Christ Jesus. We commit everyone here into your hands. We pray and ask you, Lord, that your will be done. We pray, Lord, that you will allow this occasion here to be an occasion of life and living in the name of Jesus. So our friend, brother, has departed to be forever in eternity. We pray that someone here this afternoon will get to know you so that they can embrace he who is a resurrection and life. Bless everything that will proceed this evening, Lord. We give you thanks for doing it in Jesus' blessed name. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Please remain standing. We're going to have the first lesson as we read by Carol Reed Howard, Psalms 46. Carol Reed Howard.
Good evening. The Psalm is 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. There is a river, the streams, whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen rage, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come. Come, behold the works of the Lord. What desolation he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease into the ends of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathens. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah.
You now sing the hymn, And Can It Be? For me, for all. At this time, we're going to have a eulogy by Fiona Goodman.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I stand here before you today to share the story of the beautiful life of Tariq Sabi Howard. He was born on August 8, 1994. He was the son of Marcia Goodman and Carl Howard, stepson of Carol, brother of Tariq, Terry, Tarika, Jamal, and Andre. And most of all, he was a remarkable father to Nigel Howard. I'm sure we all could agree that over the last few weeks, our memories of Terry came flashing back. His father, Carl, cherishes the memories of feeding his little baby every night, and after watching as his stomach began to swell with every gulp of tea. Soon after, he would retire to his aunt Marie's bedroom to sleep. It was actually from this practice that his nickname came about, when eventually everyone started calling this sleepy baby the nickname Sabi. Sabi always saw the best in people. In fact, his cousin finally recalls that shortly after she received her license, Sabi was the only one brave enough to ride in the car with her. And even though she was nervous being a first-time driver, Sabi always believed in her and encouraged her on every turn. Sabi was the best friend to his siblings. They could always confide in him, and he would keep their secrets. His sister Tarika said she would go to him for advice, and he would always reassure her. If ever she was feeling down, his nickname for her was Plucky, and he made sure that she knew how much he loved her, whether he said it or planted a kiss on her cheek. He loved his brothers, Terry, Jamal, Andre, and Tarek dearly, and the bond they shared unbreakable. He treated all of their children like his own, and he would do anything and give anything to make sure his brothers were good. Indeed, he was his brother's keeper. Sabi is known for being loving and always offering to help all. These are traits he exhibited from a young boy, and many elderly persons in the neighborhood recall him offering to assist them in carrying their shopping bags. I could personally attest to him cheering up whenever he was sad. As a young girl, I remember always having fun whenever I was with Sabi. One memory was my friend because I felt like I sure that I was taught when it was done. He always looked out for me and tried to steer me in the right direction. He was raised in a spiritual household where we all attended Sunday school at this very church. He always took part in reciting poems for Christmas and Easter programs. The most memorable one was when he was one of the three wise men in the Christmas nativity play. I believe everyone who was there would agree that we can never forget those three little wise men who eagerly sang chorus on a bumpy camel ride. He stuck to his spirituality even after Sunday school lessons, and he kept reading scriptures and counseling young persons to have a positive outlook on life. Sabi developed a love of sports from his days at Westbury Primary School. There he took part in many activities, including football. He then received numerous medals and trophies for his stellar performance in these matches. Sabi continued to pursue his love of football in his adulthood, and is still remembered for always scoring a hat trick whenever he played at Passage Road Pasture. At the Beverly Hills Football Club, he is revered for his talent
and skill. Perhaps his biggest achievement in his football career was when he competed for the St. Michael District in the football tournament held by the Delphines. Their Sabi was in ultimate game mode. He was focused, he played competitively, and showcased his natural skills. This soon led to their victory by the end of the football tournament. We all remember Sabi as spontaneous and a lover of life. From a tender age, he always enjoyed spending time with his family and friends, whether it was pitching marbles till late at night, diving off the floor at Brandon's Beach, riding his bicycle everywhere, or playing video games. He just had a divine presence, and every time he was around, he brought his light and his love, and there was always laughter. Sabi and his brother Terry took part in kite-flying competitions at Missouri Primary School, where he would show his innovation and creativity. Every year, they came up with new ideas on how to create the best kite, and they often won medals for their kite-flying skills and designs. He truly was capable of doing anything, and he showed this at the dance contest with his cousins with Mario and Adio. The three of them took to the stage and excellently executed many dance moves, such as the frog back and the rocket. Another love of his was to travel. Nadia's mother recalls their first trip to the Spanish-speaking country, Venezuela. He met and interacted with so many locals who soon became his friends, although the only two Spanish words Sabi knew were hola and amigo. He loved the ocean and was a fantastic swimmer, and he insisted that Nadia learn how to swim as well. To know Sabi was to know that he loved Christmas, from the decorating to the gifts to the hand cutters. He was the kind of person who loved to share and help others, and this is exactly what he would be doing during the season. After Nadia was born, he made sure he spent every Christmas and birthday with her. She was his best friend, and they would do everything together. He always made sure that she knew he was his princess, and the first love of his life. Sabi loved his parents. I still remember when he would cling to his mother's chest every time he saw her, even though he was starting to become an adolescent. Even as an adult, he would shower his mother's face with kisses to show that he loved her, and I'm sure his father would never forget the many times he said to him, "Papa, I love you." Whenever he was around his parents and his daughter, you could bet that there would be a broad grin covering his face. In the last conversation we had, he told me all the positive plans he had for his life and his future. And in that moment, Sabi didn't even realize how much of a positive impact he had already made in the lives of so many people. In all of our interactions, he was like always laughing and smiling and sharing his love. We will all miss you, Sabi. You were the best friend, the best cousin, the best brother, the best father, and the best son that we could ever ask for. Continue to sleep in peace. We love you.
We'll now have a poem by Nadia Howard, followed by a tribute and song by Princess Bess. Nadia and then Princess Bess.
Yeah. My tribute in song was requested by Sadie's mom, Smarts, and it will be singing God Needing an Angel by Ruki. I raise my hand and my lighter in your memory. I know your days are brighter, even though you're not here with me. So sad to say goodbye, but I know that way up high in the sky, God needed an angel to do His work. God needed an angel, so He took you from this earth. I plan to keep your memory burning like this flame. And anywhere it takes me, I'll carry on your name. We will miss you so, but there's one thing I know. God needed an angel to do His work. God needed an angel and took you from this earth. But I know wherever I may go, no matter what I do, I'm gonna keep this flame burning, save it just for you. No matter where I go, no matter what I do, I'm gonna keep your flame burning just for you. 'Cause God needed an angel to do His work. God needed an angel, so He took you from this earth. Because God needed an angel to do His work. God needed an angel, so Sabi, you left this earth, but we miss you so.
God needed an angel. At this time, we're going to have the second lesson, John 14, 1 to 6, by Fana Brown.
Good afternoon. Can everybody stand, please? Reading is taken from John 14, chapters 1 to 6. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And where I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know where thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, In the way, the truth, and the life, no man cometh unto the Father but by me. It's reading.
You may be seated. At this time, we're going to sit back and listen to what the man of God has to say this evening.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Sister Lawrence, and thank you, folks, for coming out to celebrate the life of Tariq Sebi, a great person. We give the Lord thanks for him, Sebi, as you heard in the eulogy, was one of our Sunday school children, and we pray that his daughter will continue in his step in church and being close to the Lord. We extend our condolences to his mom, Smart. We are a family. We've been together for many years. And Daddy Carl, Naja, pray that you will be strong in the Lord and that you will seek to follow Jesus. And to many siblings and cousins and friends and family, we're here today because of the love that you have for Sebi, and we're here to be encouraged to continue to go on. Let's bow our hearts in prayer. Father, this afternoon we thank you that in the midst of troubling times, we can look to you who still the waters. We can look to you, Lord, who comfort hearts. And we can look to you who has given us hope in the midst of despair, in the midst of darkness. We pray, Lord, that you will continue to comfort the family of Tariq, his mom, his dad, his daughter, his siblings, dear Lord, his friends, his extended family members, dear Lord, that you will visit them, hold them, dear Lord, in your arms and embrace them and give birth to the hope that you have given to all of us in Christ Jesus. We look to your words of comfort this afternoon. We pray that you will bless your words to our hearts and to our understanding. You said that your words will not return unto you void. We pray that we accomplish whatever purpose that you have us to accomplish this afternoon. So bless your word, dear Lord, which you said will abide forever in our souls. For we are not to live by natural food alone, but by every word that proceeds of your mouth. Bless us to this end, dear Father, and we give thanks and praise for you. In Jesus' name, amen. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. These were the words of Jesus. And this afternoon, I want to address you on the topic, Christ, the answer for troubled hearts in this troubled world. Christ, the answer for troubled hearts in this troubled world. Job said it. Job said, a man that is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. Jesus said that in these days in which we are in, that there will be distress of nations. There will be distress of lands. There will be perplexities.
men's hearts will fail them for fear. Paul said that these days that we're in are evil days. And therefore we need to redeem the time. Sebi has caused us to be here to focus upon some realities that we need to focus upon. And Paul said that we need to redeem the time, so he reminds us that we need to treasure the days which we have. When I was going through the program, I saw that at one of the recent funerals for a family member, Terry was a pallbearer. We are to embrace the reality that these days are really full of trouble. And to be prepared to deal with the trouble with resources which have been made available to us. And we thank the Lord for Terry's life. And we also thank him that his final offer to us, or gift to us, we can be here to hear words of encouragement and words of life. So yes, we're here to celebrate his life. And we're here to be made aware that all of us have in these troubled days a great enemy. And that great enemy is death. But we here also to know that that enemy needs not to be our great enemy, but to be an individual who has been defeated, and we should know it. Jesus wants our hearts not to be troubled. In the text which we read, Jesus was a man of sorrow, acquainted with grief. He was a man touched with the feelings of infirmities, everything that you will feel today. His marks, his dad, his siblings, his friends, all the pain and the grief that you will feel today, Christ felt all of it. He came into the world to be acquainted with grief and pain and sorrow. Jesus, when he uttered these words, he had spent some time with the disciples. He knew that a few hours ahead of him that there would be a time of great sorrow because the cross was ahead of him. He also knew that one of his disciples was about to betray him for 30 pieces of silver. He also knew that his right-hand man, Peter, before the cock will crow, will deny him not once, not twice, but three times. So we understand that Jesus Christ, the God-man, we are told in the chapter 13 that he was troubled in spirit. Yeah, he was troubled in spirit, and some of us today, we are troubled. We are troubled as we embrace what happened. We embrace the troubles of life. We embrace the enemy raging ceaselessly to trap us. We our hearts are troubled. Jesus said to the disciples that he was leaving to go. And their hearts were troubled too. In the midst of his own issues which he had to deal with, namely the cross where all of our sins will be placed on him. He will become sin for us so that we can become the righteousness of God. He laid aside his discomforts to encourage those whom he loved. And by extension, he is encouraging us today. He has left these words for our hearts to be comforted. And therefore, we will listen to Jesus as he speaks to us today. In the midst of this troubled times, in this troubling world, in the presence of that great enemy death. And he says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. You must believe in the promises of God. I'm certain that the many years that Terry spent here in Sunday school, he would have heard of the many promises of God. He would have learned the recitations which recited those promises. And those promises were placed in his heart and etched in his heart. Sabi wants us to listen to Jesus today. Believe in God. Believe in the promises which he has made. The promises that he came into this world to save, to seek, to deliver, to give us power to live. He came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. Believe that. Those who believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Believe this promise. Believe in God. Believe in his promises. Believe also in me. These were the words of Jesus. Believe also that I am the realization of the promise. From the beginning until then, all those promises were made, and Jesus came to fulfill every one of those promises. He was the word that became flesh and dwelt among us. So the promises are real. So he said, if you believe in the promises, believe that those promises can be realized because I'm the fulfillment of those promises, and those promises are here with you today. So friends, believe the promises of God. Believe everything that you would have heard that God has promised you in the scriptures. Seize them. Hide them in your hearts because it's important. These are the promises. He continued by encouraging his men by declaring to them, in my Father's house are many mansions. In other words, there is a better place for us. And this place is in our Father's house. It is big enough to hold everyone. So there's a place that's better than this troubled world that we are in. We'll be faced with so much dangers as we embrace what Job said, few days are full of trouble. This is not a place for us to feel excited over or feel that we are comfortable here or feel that we can have joy here or get true satisfaction. This place is referred to by David as the very valley of the shadow of death. But there is a better place. Terry wants us this afternoon to know that there is a better place. Yeah, we must redeem the time, we must seize the opportunity, we must be circumspect, and we must let our minds be fixed upon the better place. Hallelujah. Jesus reinforced, he says, if it were not so, I, who am the way, the truth, and the life, I would have told you there is a better place for you, for all of us this afternoon. So what words of comfort? There's something better for us. And hear what he says again. He says, oh, there's a place that is much better than anything that you can imagine because it is in the house of the Almighty God. But then he says this, I am going to prepare a place for you. And folks, this afternoon, we want to embrace that promise. Christ is saying to us that he went to prepare a place for all of us. Hallelujah. So there's a place prepared for us. It's for us now to get the keys, to seize the opportunity. Not to get a house, a condominium, something promised us by the government or by inheritance, by a loved one, but to be able to get a place in a mansion that eyes cannot imagine, that Christ who created everything has gone to prepare for us in God's house. Hallelujah. So that's what we can be excited over, that there is a place in our Father's house prepared for us. It is away from us. It's out of this troubled world. But it's prepared for us. We can look forward to it. I'm certain that that was in the back of Terry's mind as he made preparations to come through this life and to prosper in this life and to prepare for the reality that comes after life. Because in order for us really to be satisfied here, our minds must be filled with the satisfaction that comes from over there. Yeah, you might be happy here, but true joy comes True happiness comes because of the joy that's in us. So listen to what Christ said as well. Not only am I going to prepare a place for you, but I will come again to receive you unto myself. You hear this promise? Believe the promises. Embrace the promises. He said he's coming again to receive us unto himself. That where he is, in this place of unimaginable bliss and splendor, that we will be able to be with him forever and ever and ever. That where I am, there ye may be also. So this afternoon, we believe in Christ. We believe his promises. We know that he is the beginning and the end, and all of his promises to us are sure and they are real. Let our minds not to be settled with this troubled world, this world in which it seems that death has a temporal dominion. But let's embrace the promise of our Savior, who declared that he is the resurrection and the life. That whosoever believe in him, though they be separated or dead, yet they live. And whosoever liveth and believeth shall never die. That's a promise that we can embrace this afternoon. And embracing our promise, we can also look beyond this present troubled world and look to that place that the promise was made that is prepared for every one of us. Hallelujah. In the last book of the Bible, the Apostle John, who was experiencing trouble as well, got a glimpse into tomorrow. And the glimpse which he got, he saw that the Jesus who had promised him that he was going to prepare a place for all of us, he saw him in his height and glory. And this is what he said to us. He says, "And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the dwelling place of God is with men. And he will dwell with them." The promise is that there's a day in the future where God himself will dwell with us. Didn't he say that he will come again to receive us unto himself so that where he is, we will be also, that we will be able to dwell with him? And then we remember from our Sunday school days that the psalmist declared that in the presence of the Lord, there is the fullness of joy. So despite the sorrow, the pain, and everything, that there is a place with unspeakable joy in the presence of the Lord. I will dwell with them. And they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. What a great promise in the midst of these troubled times in which we are in. Yeah, you know about the troubles of the time, but there's hope. Listen. Jesus said to us that we believe in God, believe also in him. Believe in his promises. Believe that he has actually prepared a place for us which is far better than anything that we have seen. Has a nicer pillow than the one you have left at home. A place that is enviable. And this is what John saw and realized there, over there, where we are supposedly going to, where we can embrace this afternoon, where we can claim our place in our Father's house. Over there, there shall be no more tears over there. There's no need to be crying over there. There's a place which Christ has prepared for us where there's no crying. We pray today that we will have the faith to be able to embrace that as a reality. That there's actually a place that has been prepared where there will be no more tears. There will be no more separation. In this place that he has prepared for all of us, over there, in that prepared place, there will be no more death. Yeah, dying is now. It seems that the Grim Reaper has authority now, but the time will come when he will have no authority. I will also indicate to you now that you who know Jesus Christ, when he came in this world and died on the cross, he destroyed him who had power over death. That's the devil. That's why he can claim over us the hope and that for those who are in Christ, death, where is your strength? Grave, where is your victory? There's a sense of invincibility that you can embrace today who don't know him as your Savior and Lord. To be able to walk with him, not ever being separated from death, by death. Hallelujah. Paul said that, and he said indeed that if you embrace the love that was offered, that there is nothing that can separate you from that love. Not things present, not things to come, not height, not death, nothing can separate you from the love of Christ Jesus and the promise that he's made to you. So that place that has been prepared for us, where Jesus said that our hearts need not to be troubled today, because there is better ahead of us, there will be no more sorrow over there either. No more crying over there. Most of us who are over 50, no more pain over there. For all of those things shall pass away. Christ assured, as he's made these promises and he is the realization of these promises, we can embrace those promises today. And I know for sure that Sebi will want us to be here to hear these words that our hearts need not to be troubled in this troubled world that we are in. Our hearts need just to believe the promises of God and the reality that those promises have been realized in us believing in Jesus Christ as our Savior, as our Deliverer, as he who destroyed death and brought life and light and immortality to us today. So as we celebrate the life of Terry Sebi, as we thank the Lord for lending him to us, as we reflect upon the spirit which he had that was encouraging, as we think in totality his entire life, let our faith take us into the promise of Scripture today, that this hope, our hearts need not to be troubled because Christ came and gave us this opportunity for all of us to spend tomorrow and the tomorrows of tomorrow in a place of splendor, of bliss, a place of joy, a place of peace. He came to offer us comfort. Christ today is offering us care. He's offering us compassion. Christ today is offering us hope in this hopeless world. Christ today is offering us rest. And Sebi wants us to know Christ today, the object of his thoughts in this kind of school, and as he will go into his lessons and read his scriptures, he knew that Christ offered rest in this troubled world. He wants us all to know that there is rest in Christ. He wants us to be inspired by scripture. As we know the promises, to be inspired, to be motivated to approach Jesus and to embrace his promises and know that there is hope ahead of what we call the grave. There's a better man ahead. S. Sebi wants to know that Christ offers all of us security. Security. As we walk in this world, you may think that you are naked and you are not secured, but Christ is present to be our security. He will be our shield in the midst of this troubled world. So we can be secured in Christ. He promised us salvation, deliverance from anything that would be against his will for our lives. And lastly, Sebi wants us to trust God. You have many troubles. There are many perplexities around. Many uncertainties that we are in. As we breathe, we are breathing troubled air. But we have to trust God. Like, believe in his promises. Trust in his words. Get into the Bible and read the Bible and claim all his promises. And then when you are overwhelmed by the conditions of this sorrowful world, look beyond that and look to the hope that is there, that's been promised us in Scripture, and trust that the Lord will deliver all of His promises. I believe that that's what Tariq will want us to embrace this evening, that truly in Jesus Christ, that there is hope for us, that truly Christ is the answer for all of our pain, of our sorrow, of our trouble. Christ is the answer for death and dying. Christ is the answer for all of the sicknesses and diseases. Christ is the answer. He wants us to know that the God of his Sunday school era, and the God whom he learned about and helped to bring him to the time of his own departure, that the Lord today is able to keep every promise that was made to every one of us. And the promise that he has made for all of us, that there is a place in heaven, in the Father's house, prepared for every one of us. And all we need to do is to trust Jesus Christ, believe in him, embrace the promises, live the life that he will give us to live, and so we can face our greatest enemy and these troublous times as more than conquerors, as victors and not victims. Let the departure of Sebi into eternity cause us this afternoon to embrace the hope that we have in Christ Jesus, cause us to embrace the promise that has been made to us, that there is a place prepared for all of us so that we can go there. It's guaranteed greater. It's guaranteed greater than even you going home this afternoon. If you believe in him, you know indeed that that place is already prepared. In Jesus' blessed name, Father. Father, we thank you for your words, which has gone forth. We know, dear Lord, that you have occasioned everything which has happened here today, because your word declares that all things work together for good, for those who love you, for those who are the called according to your purpose. And Lord, we prayed that at the departure of our loved one, Tariq, that some soul or souls here this afternoon will embrace Jesus Christ as their Lord and their Savior, so that they, when the time comes from there to face this enemy, death, that's occasioned us being here, that they can look boldly in the face of this arch enemy and say, as Paul said, "Oh death, where is your sting? I have Christ in me, and therefore you have no part in me." So, Lord, quicken the hearts and souls of those who do not know you this afternoon. We know that you said that you are willing that none shall perish. I pray that you open doors, dear Lord, for souls to enter into those doors, that you will calm the troubled waters of life today. I pray that you will comfort, dear Lord, Smarts and Carl, and you'll be there, Lord, to hold his daughter's hand and guide her as she grows and matures, dear Lord. You'll be there to comfort, dear Lord, to Terry's siblings, dear Father. We pray that those who came in the Sunday school with him, that they will return to their first love so that they can live their lives there victoriously, experiencing true joy and not fleeting happiness, Lord. We pray for the entire family, that their family, dear Lord, will continue to embrace you and exalt Jesus Christ, and that will embrace the words and the promises of Scripture, so that they will be covered on the blood and the life of Christ in the name of Jesus. Father, we know that you are willing that none will perish. So I claim every soul here this afternoon for your honor and for your glory. And my prayer, Lord, is that everyone here one day will enter into that prepared place in your house in glory, where we abide with you forever and ever and ever. In Jesus' blessed name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Please stand as we recite the Lord's Prayer, and then we're going to sing, "Let There Be Peace on Earth." We stand as we recite the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord. As we leave, we will sing the hymn, Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Peace that was made to be with God as Thank you. Listen, I tell you a mystery. You will not all sleep, and we shall be changed in a flash, in a twinkling of an eye, in the last trumpet. The trumpet will sound, the dead will raise imperishable. We will be changed, and the saying that is written will come to truth. Therefore, I swallowed up, in victory. Or death, where is your sting? Where, or death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, the power of sin to the Lord. For thanks be to God who gives us the perfect through our Lord Jesus Christ. We have come now to commit the body.
Parted friend Tariq to his kindred dust. The spirit we leave with God, for we know the merciful judge of all the earth will do right. Let us who remains dedicate ourselves anew to live in the fear and love of God, that we may obtain an abundant entrance into the heavenly kingdom. We therefore commit his body dust to dust, ashes to ashes, in hope of the resurrection of life eternal. In Jesus' blessed name, amen. Father, we thank you for the life and witness of Tariq. You gave him life, dear Lord, and you take it back away from him. We pray, Lord, that you will comfort hearts that mourn now. And Father, that we will keep our eyes upon you, our blessed hope, to know that after death, there is a promise of a resurrection. In Jesus' blessed name, amen. Let's sing a song in the street by and by. You have your programs to sing? Where's over the way? Come to me.
The beautiful show
in the sweet,
in the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
We shall sing on that beautiful shore.
We shall sing on that beautiful shore.
The melodious sounds of the bliss.
The melodious sounds of the bliss. And our spirit shall sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessing of Christ.
In the sweet.
In the sweet. By and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore.
In the sweet.
In the sweet. By and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. You are bountiful, Father.
We will offer our tribute of praise. Glorious gift of his love,
glorious gift of his love,
and the blessings that hallow all
days.
In the sweet,
in the sweet, by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet, by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sleep, by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sleep, by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Let's sing him Blessed Assurance.
Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God.
Born of his spirit.
Born of his spirit, washed in his blood.
This is my story.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission. Perfect.
Vision
of the church.
Angels descending.
Angels descending. Bring from
above. Echoes of mercy.
Echoes of mercy. Whispers of love.
This is my story.
This is my story. This is my song. Praise my Savior. All the love. This is my story. This is my song. Praise my Savior. All the day long. Perfect submission. All is at rest.
I am my Savior.
I am my Savior. I'm happy and blessed.
Watching and waiting.
Looking above.
Filled with his goodness.
Lost in his love.
This is my story.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long.
This is my story.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long.
Praise the Lord. Next song, Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Great is Thy Faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with Thee. Thou changest not, Thy compassions they fail not. As Thou hast been, so forever wilt be. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have need is Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Summer and winter, springtime and harvest.
Sun, moon, and stars.
Sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness. To Thy great faithfulness, mercy and love. Great is Thy faithfulness, great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, Thy hand hath provided. Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord unto me. Pardon for sin.
And a peace that endureth.
Peace that endureth.
They own their presence.
Thine own their presence to cheer and to guard.
Strength for today.
Strength for today. And bright hope for tomorrow.
Blessings all mine.
Blessings all mine. This 10,000 years.
Great is Thy faithfulness.
Great is Thy faithfulness. Great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
All I've needed.
All I have needed, Thy hand hath provided.
Great is Thy faithfulness.
Great is Thy faithfulness, Lord unto me.
Great is Thy faithfulness.
Great is Thy faithfulness. Great is Thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed,
Praise the Lord. Vitamin D. Vitamin D. Sunlight helps against the coronavirus. Let's sing this wonderful hymn, "When Peace Like a River."
When peace like a river, a endless my river.
When sorrows.
When sorrows like
sea, whatever my lot. Thou hast taught me to say. It is well.
It is well.
Though Satan should buffet. Your trial shall come. Let this blessed assurance control. It is well. My sin or the bliss.
My sin or the bliss of this glorious.
My sin not in part but the whole.
My sin not in part but the whole.
It's nailed to his cross. And I bear it no more.
And I bear it no more.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Because it's well.
It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul.
Here's a promise on the Lord.
And the Lord is the pain. Then the pain shall be found.
The clouds be rolled back as a scroll. The trump shall resound.
The trump shall resound. And the Lord shall be found.
Even so, it is well with my soul.
It is well.
And Lord, haste the day.
And Lord, haste the day. When the pain shall be high. The clouds be rolled back as a stone. The trump shall be sung. And the Lord shall be sung.
Even so. Praise the Lord.
It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul.
Praise the Lord. You're seeing amazing grace. We're going to just finish. Just a minute. Okay. When they're laying the flowers, they do this. Right, hang around. Okay. As the flowers are being laid, we will sing the song Amazing Grace. The song Amazing Grace. I once was lost. Twas grace that thought my heart to fear. My grace, my fears relieve. How precious did grace appear? The hour. The Lord has promised good to me. He will my shield and portion be. Through many dangers, toils, and snares. This grace have brought me safe thus far. And grace will lead me home. No less days to sing God's praise. Praise God. Praise God. Right here. That was it. Amen. Now may the God of grace and peace, who through the blood of eternal covenant brought back from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, equip you with everything good for doing his will, and may he work in us what is pleasing to him, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you for your sharing your love and support in this hour of bereavement. Thank you for coming to the funeral and to the graveside. We pray that you will continue to pray for the family as they continue to reflect upon the life of the champion of a young man, Terry. The family thank you. And we will pray for them as they will spend the evening in quiet reflection on the life of Terry Sabi. God bless you and thanks for everything.
Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you.